Rahul, and I'm basically from Ludhiana, Punjab. So I'm currently pursuing PG from IIM Kozhikode. So talking a bit about my background, I've done Bachelor of Commerce Honours from TRICE Bangalore. Post that, I did a few internships here and there in different domains to figure out like what I want to do. Post that, I worked with a chartered accountancy firm for approximately 9 months, and then I came into IIM. So it's a marathon, not a race. You know, that what I felt was I put in a lot of efforts in the starting few months, and then sort of my energy got drained out because I had to look into different things. Similarly, work is going on. Similarly, I have to take into CAT classes also. I have to take mocks also. So at that time, your energy goes down, and especially on those days, you feel like it's really worth it, all the efforts you're putting in. And I can guarantee you, even if it's in the online scenario, we all guys are having all the fun and we are learning a lot, you know, on both sides, educationally and other things also. So I started a bit late in July. So mine was sort of a crash course sort of a thing. So I started in July, and since I was working also at that time, one tip for the WorkX guys, have a proper structure for the next week. That okay, you know, I have these 3 mocks to take in, I have these 2 sections mocks to take in, and this is the learning I need to get out of the next week. So that helps you to get, you know, manage your time in your works also, for the CAT also, and maybe if possible get a social life also during the weekdays, because that is too important, you know, else you won't be able to sustain the whole program. So yeah, I gave CAT, got a pretty decent percentage, 98 point something. And then, GDPI is another hurdle that you need to cross. I guess that is a bigger hurdle as compared to CAT, because then you need to really portray what you are. Because CAT is sort of an elimination. GDPI is a selection process. LRDI is not about how, you know, how good you are in LRDI, it's all about selection. So if you get select a easy set, you're good to go. Hard set, make God bless you. So I went, solved all the books, Proyra Endeavor. Then I solved, the sheets or something like that, Proyra itself, the Endeavor. Then I went for the small sets, like 45 minutes, 40 questions, the one we have in Endeavor. So this gave me a brief idea of what all questions we do have in LRDI. So once you have seen all the questions, then go for take homes. So at that you could, even gamble, put across, okay, this set could be targeted, this set could be targeted, this set could be targeted, and same could be done in, section quizzes. So you could actually, so because UIM, you have a back in the mind, here I want to score a good percentage. But take homes, no one is actually checking that. So take homes would be really a sort of practice thing to test your strategy in LRDI. Take a risk, go for bigger sets, go for sets that you might not even like. And the other thing is have a strength in LRDI. Maybe, what happens is you can't focus both on LRDI, LR and DI. So what I did was I focused majorly on LR so that, even any questions of LR comes, I can solve that. So the DI is somewhat irrespective of that, I can solve it. So that your attention gets not diverted into 2 different things. Maybe you could focus on that, and even a difficult set comes in for LR and you wrongly choose that, you are able to solve that. And I can confirm this strategy works because I got a good, like DI was my push over to for my good percentile. Have a hold or see what is really happening in the world. So GKS 2 pass, static and current. Static would be done afterwards because you won't want to compromise on your other learnings. Maybe focus on cons, LR or DI, whatever it is. But have a keep in the mind that what is really happening in the world. So current affairs could be taken up right now. The static part could be taken afterwards. Read newspapers, maybe go for InShots so that your time could be saved. Or ET Prime or even the Ken is really good. So that could be taken into consideration. This reading would also help for your VRC and in your B schools also. like currently I have 5 case preps to study before tomorrow, before my next class. So that actually helps a lot in P schools also. I think we shouldn't focus on the hours. Rather than we should have targets like, you know, I need to have 3 mocks given by this month, or 3 section tests, or complete these sort of books. So, you know, hours would specifically define that, okay, you need to put 5 hours or 4 hours. But having targets would be a better approach to go by. So then your approach becomes really structured. And apart from that, I can speak for the WorkX guys. So what I used to do is, like, I used to give around 2 hours before my work and 2 hours before my, you know, after my work. So yeah, extra effort is needing. Maybe 2 hours before could be given to VRC, you know, reading stuff, practicing some RCs. And the post time could be given to cons each day, alternate days cons, alternate days LRDI. The top B schools, everyone should apply to everyone, every college. Maybe, you know, you can skip snap, like Symbiosis if you're not interested in marketing or something like that, or maybe skip Mica if you're not into marketing enough. But rest, generally all top 20-25 B schools you need to apply. And after that, maybe keep a backup of 2 or 3 colleges which you might consider after getting it. Like maybe IMT Ghaziabad could be considered as a backup, or Goa Institute of Management could be considered as a backup. So that strategy could be followed while selecting these schools. Like, you guys should go and literally check every college's selection criteria. So every college has a different composite score. So in, you know, a lot of colleges, you commerce grads do get a diversity points. So rather than being at disadvantage, you guys are at an advantage. So that's a total myth that, you know, we are at a disadvantage. You guys don't need to kill in every section. You know, one section would be enough to get you at a 99% mark. Maybe get a benchmark of 90 percentile or even 85 percentile in one section, and score around 90 in one section and a 99 in another section. That would literally cross the 99 benchmark. So yeah, even if you're not good at quant, that won't really affect. Focus on other parts, DLLR, you know, if you're good at it, make it your strongest point. Score above 99 and VRC, OKish 95, that would help, you know, get good to go. You're good to go. So usually first 3 months or the first term would be really hectic, given that you need to understand what all is happening. You would be having, you know, CV processes, making process happening, committee interviews happening, and then if you're an engineer, you would getting, you know, new subjects you never learned or listened about. So first 3 months would be hectic, but post that it really becomes really chill. So you do have time to do some projects, you do have time to do live projects and all. So people even do CFAs along with MBA. So, but that's post first term. So first term is for the first 3 months, you could say, yeah, you don't have a time for even your family. Like, maybe you could motivate yourself from the perks or the objectives you'll be fulfilling when you clear this order. So, you know, people have, you know, incentives like I would have good job, cash and all. So that could be a motivation, or if you really want to get back into college life, that could be your motivation, you know, drivers. So try, maybe focus on that also to motivate yourself.